After years of operation, the International Space Station is beginning to show signs of deterioration. Technical issues are becoming more frequent, and the station is nearing the end of its operational life. Fortunately, a new wave of commercial space stations is emerging. Several promising initiatives are under development, some of which are expected to be operational as early as next year. Let's discuss them all in today's episode of NR Studio. One of NASA's candidates, the Starship space station, tops my list. I originally planned to place it in second place, but Starship's recent achievements, combined with its incredible potential, now make it the most compelling option. More importantly, Starship may be a crucial element in allowing the US to maintain its lead over China in its quest for space supremacy. While originally conceived as a rocket, Starship's design has always hinted at more. From the beginning, Starship has been envisioned as a flexible platform that can transition into a fully operational space station. This adaptability stems from several key advantages that set Starship apart from other spacecraft currently in development. The first and most obvious advantage is its size. Starship is over 50 meters tall and 9 meters in diameter. Within this vast structure, the nose cone alone offers a habitable height of about 18 meters. This yields nearly 1,000 cubic meters of habitable space, even after accounting for the tapered nose. For illustration, this is similar to, and in some cases even exceeds, the total usable volume of the entire ISS. Furthermore, this measurement is not even the final capacity. Starship has the potential to expand in numerous ways. Future iterations, such as the anticipated V4, which would increase the spacecraft to 61 meters, would provide even more internal space. Furthermore, SpaceX could redesign Starship for long-term habitation. After orbit, its fuel tanks could be removed or repurposed, extending tens of meters to increase habitation space. This change could create more than 3,000 cubic meters of habitable space within a single spacecraft. The 9-meter diameter also facilitates internal shielding against cosmic radiation, an important consideration for long-term missions.
The scalability factor is also remarkable. SpaceX has the capability to launch multiple Starships, convert them into individual units, and then assemble them. The wheel-shaped station design already exists, with a central core connected to various Starship modules arranged in a circular formation. Such an architecture could accommodate an unprecedented number of individuals and goods, reshaping our perception of space exploration, commerce, and even tourism. Another important aspect is cost. Starship's stainless steel construction, methane and oxygen fuel, rapid production methods, and complete reusability significantly reduce costs. Musk has projected that each launch will ultimately cost around $2 million. Considering this figure, SpaceX could theoretically invest nearly $100 million to build and launch a substantial station. In contrast, the ISS cost approximately $100 billion to build, yet only supports a crew of fewer than 10 people. Some might argue that such a space station is still a long way off. Nevertheless, Starship is making rapid progress. Its 10th test flight has already been successfully completed, and the next year will see the acceleration of the V3 iteration. SpaceX's immediate goals include achieving orbit, transporting 100 tons of payload, and demonstrating in-space refueling capabilities. The company has also set ambitions for uncrewed missions to the Moon and Mars. With these goals, the prospect of building a Starship-based space station no longer seems like mere science fiction. Challenges certainly lie ahead. Building such a facility would likely take longer than completing smaller, more conventional projects. However, when considering its size, cost-effectiveness, flexibility, and alignment with SpaceX's broader goals, the Starship space station emerges as the idea with the greatest promise. It represents a bold vision for the future of human space exploration. Now, let's take a closer look at this expansive space station. For many, this initiative deserves a top spot. I once ranked it first on my own list before SpaceX's recent progress changed that order. Nonetheless, VAST remains one of the most significant and promising endeavors for a commercial space station underway. One of the VAST station's key strengths is its progress. While many competitors are still in the concept stage, VAST has completed production of its initial module, Haven 1. This module is now transitioning to the next phase, where engineers will integrate additional internal systems and prepare for a series of evaluations. Based on the current schedule, Haven 1 is scheduled to launch in May of next year. If this schedule is maintained, Haven 1 will be the first commercial space station to reach orbit, a significant achievement.
While other initiatives continue to face setbacks, a key benefit stands out: collaboration. VAST has established a close partnership with SpaceX, recognized as a leader in contemporary space exploration. The modules will be delivered to orbit using Falcon 9 rockets, renowned for their reliability and track record of accomplishment. Once operational, the station will receive supplies via SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft, which has supported the ISS for over a decade. Furthermore, VAST intends to incorporate Starlink into its operations. This global satellite network has proven its capacity to provide high-speed communications in normal situations, emergencies, and even while in space. Integrating Starlink connectivity will significantly enhance the station's communications and data exchange capabilities. Growth potential is another aspect that sets VAST apart. Haven 1, with dimensions of 10.1 meters long and 4.4 meters in diameter, offers 45 cubic meters of usable space. However, this is just the beginning. The larger Haven 2 module will double this available space. Initially, four Haven 2 modules will be connected in a straight configuration. After Starship delivers the central core module, equipped with four docking ports, these Haven 2 modules will be reorganized into an X-shaped design. Four more Haven 2 modules will be added, further enhancing the station's living space and research capabilities. The design philosophy behind the VAST station is also commendable. The organization prioritizes cleanliness, cutting-edge technology, and comfort in its design, ensuring that crews not only have the necessary equipment for survival and research, but also an environment that feels like a second home. This emphasis on ease of use and overall quality of life is what sets VAST apart from existing stations and spacecraft, which often feel cramped and functional. Collectively, these advantages position VAST as a prime candidate to replace the ISS. Its proactive launch schedule, strong partnerships, and ambitious growth strategy position it in a highly competitive field. As the ISS nears its retirement, the VAST space station presents a timely and highly capable alternative. The third station I've chosen is the Axiom Space Station. The most intriguing aspect of this project is its unique construction method. It's akin to nurturing a bird in a nest, and once it's fully grown, it flies away. In this scenario, the nest represents the ISS. Initially, the Axiom station would be connected to the ISS and dependent on its systems. Once mature and ready to support itself, it would separate and function as an independent orbital station. This approach offers clear advantages.
Starting as a validated and established platform component, the Axiom station has benefited from the trust and support provided in its early stages. Simultaneously, Axiom Space has continued to enhance its expertise through focused missions to the ISS, gaining insight into the intricacies of station management while preparing for its own growth. Similar to VAST Station, Axiom will rely heavily on SpaceX for both launch and operational tasks. Falcon 9 rockets will transport its modules, while Dragon spacecraft will be used for crew and supply transfers. In terms of design, the Axiom Station plans to incorporate several specialized modules. HAB 1 and HAB 2 will offer residential accommodations and research space. The research and manufacturing area will facilitate scientific activities and include a 360-degree observation facility. The payload thermal module will power the entire station, and the airlock module will support extravehicular activities. The living space is particularly appealing, inspired by Japanese capsule hotels, with soft, comfortable walls designed for comfort. This emphasis on habitability, alongside the observation facility, has emerged as one of the station's most appealing aspects. Despite its promise, development has been slower than anticipated. Currently, only the initial module has been completed, as many systems are still under development.
That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.